Canadian Olympic team.
Back to Matt A. The freestyle 69-kilogram quarterfinal continues. Daniel Agali in the red of Canada. Sanchez of Cuba in the blue, tied at one.
Well, we knew it would be a close match coming into it. Daniel starting to open up a little bit more, scoring that 1 point right at the end of the first period. That was a really important point. It gave Daniel some confidence in addition to tying up the match.
Agali, a native of Nigeria, in his tribe in Nigeria, wrestling was, it was part of the culture like hockey is in Canada. Daniel grew up wrestling. It's second nature to him.
Here, what he's trying to do is he's trying to get Sanchez to move. He's trying to move him with his hands, trying to move Sanchez's body so that he can make an attack. Needed to set that shot up a little bit more.
These guys are both so quick.
Well, and Sanchez is very quick on his defense. And if you don't set up that shot, you're not going to get it deep enough. You're going to have a hard time scoring.
Agali, Sanchez tied at one.
Here we see Sanchez being called for passivity again. Daniel is being far more aggressive than Sanchez in the first part of the period. Daniel puts him in the down position. Here, Daniel wants to give everything he's got. He's got to commit. He's got to open up. If he can turn Sanchez here for 2 points, he's going to have total control of the match.
He certainly has the strength to turn.
Oh, he's very strong in both his arms, his hips, and his legs. But he's just a little bit afraid to make a mistake. It is a little bit risky sometimes going for a gut wrench in this position. He just doesn't want to make a mistake.
A reminder here, the winner advances to the semifinal. The loser will not win a medal. This is the quarterfinal match in the men's 69-kilogram category. Agali Sanchez tied at one. A minute 30 left in period number two. If neither wrestler has reached 3 points at the end of regulation time, this match will go to overtime. Nice quick shot.
Well, and Daniel needs to do more of this kind of action. He needs to open it up a little bit more. He needs to attack. He's got an excellent attack when he commits, but it's so hard to commit totally when you're tentative and you don't want to make a mistake.
Why do you think he's tentative at this point? He has wrestled twice already.
There is so much pressure on him right now. You know, Canada has never won a gold medal in Olympic-style wrestling. He was the first Canadian to win a world championship. He's just got what seems like the weight of the world on his shoulders right here. And it's so hard when you're feeling that kind of pressure to be loose, to open up, and wrestle as well as he can.
Passivity against Agali. He'll be put down. Remember, last time he was in this position, he was turned for 1 point. 1-1 now.
Well, and at this point in the match, the wrestlers are a lot more sweaty than they were earlier on. Hard to do a gut wrench on somebody when they're sweaty around the ribs.
Agali fighting. He can't be turned here.
Well, I think the difference there was he's a lot sweatier, and Sanchez just slipped off just as he was going over.
15 seconds left in this match. Agali has to hold on, and he does, and he does. Scary, tension-filled moments there. 11 seconds left. 1-1 the score.
Daniel was intense enough there. He didn't let anything slip, and that's what he had to do. If he got turned there, that would have been the match, because one wrestler has to score 3 points. Sanchez would have got 2 points there to make it 3-1, and with this amount of time left in the match, it would have been almost impossible to come back. He did what he had to do there. Now he's just got to regroup, focus on wrestling in the overtime, putting together a couple really solid attacks.
He fought so hard to defend that move that maybe he hurt his left shoulder. He's on the mat now, as they show you the crowd, but he's on the mat being attended to by the Canadian doctors and trainers.
He looks all right here, ready to go.
1-1, 5 seconds left in regulation time. This match could be headed to overtime.
Well, and usually with 5 or 10 seconds left, neither wrestler will make an attack. They'll just wait for the overtime period to start.
and they move into the overtime immediately. It's 1-1. First wrestler to three wins. If it remains tied at the end of overtime, it goes to the judges.
Yes!
Look at this. Look at this.
Fantastic. That great pursuit. That's what he has to do. He shot in on the leg. Sanchez countered. Daniel kept the pursuit up.
And he turned him.
Turned him out of bounds for 2 points. Fantastic.
What a great move. You saw the explosiveness there, the quickness on his feet. Unstoppable. 3-1 at Galley. He wins here in the quarterfinal and moves on to the semi.
Well, and that's how we got to see Daniel Agali wrestling. That's his style, being powerful, pursuing the wrestlers, opening up. That was just a fantastic shot, fantastic finish.
You saw him there maybe conserving his energy in the last 10 seconds of regulation, and he exploded, just exploded
here
out of the gate in overtime.
Coming up, driving forward, he's so powerful in his upper body, knocks Sanchez onto his back, out of bounds, 2 points. Makes a good attack here. Keeps a strong position, doesn't let his head get down, keeps powering him over for 2 points.
Daniel Agali, 3-1 here in the quarterfinal. He will face Lincoln McIlravey of the USA in the semi later on day 16.
All right, thank you very much.